Now notice what God told them earlier. God said, the day you eat of that tree, you will surely die. So what began to happen here was, what happened to them was, when they entered that tree, they experienced spiritual death. When they entered that tree, the first thing they experienced was spiritual death. What is spiritual death? Spiritual death speaks about separation from God. Spiritual death. They experienced spiritual death. They died spiritually. They became separated from God. There was no longer any confidence to approach God's presence. There was now a sense of guilt and inferiority. That's why when God called on them, they went into hiding, because they had experienced spiritual death. Okay? There was now fear. There was now inferiority. There was now guilt. Okay, remember, God made them in his image and after his likeness. Therefore, they were not inferior in a sense with God. They were not inferior to God. We saw it just the two. We did not see it, but it's there that Adam named all the animals, and there was nobody. Adam had no help, no helpmate. Okay, not like his kind. Every animal had a pair. You had the male dog and the female dog. The male cat, female cat. The male fish, female fish. That was how it was. But Adam did not have a female companion. So Adam and God were having conversation. But all of a sudden now, Adam is running from God's presence. That's what sin does, because they died spiritually. When they died spiritually, they began to hide and run from God's presence. They were now living in fear all of a sudden. They were afraid. Before, Adam was never afraid of God. But now, because of eating of that fruit, fear now came into their lives. Okay? So, and of course, you know, the Bible says, later that fear has torment. Perfect love casts out fear. James says that. But also many of the sicknesses that are caused in the world today are the result of fear. You have all kind of phobias. You have all kind of emotional problems, a lot of mental issues because of fear. There are a lot of people who live in fear all the time. The fear of tomorrow, the fear of the future, the fear of yesterday, fear of, they live in fear all the time. A lot of depression based on fear of the future. People who commit suicide based on fear of the future. People live depressed and hopeless lives because of fear. So many diseases have been caused by fear. So we see sickness and disease inching in. This is fear. Fear becomes a catalyst for a lot of other illnesses. So we see that inching in. Okay, verse 10. Look at verse 11. And he said, God said to him, now who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree which I commanded you not to eat, that you should not eat of? And the man said, the woman whom you gave me, okay, whom you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree and I did eat. So he begins to see accusation. This accusation. It's her. It's him. It's her. Like my children. It's her. It's him. It's her. Daddy, it's him. It's her. I didn't do it. All kinds of stuff going on. And all of that stuff brings stress in. Stress, a lot of problems, a lot of emotional problems come because of stress. People living their lives, you know, always living in a sense of guilt and accusing other people. Some people just cannot live life without accusing somebody else. People not taking responsibility, okay? All kinds of stresses, all kinds of muscular pains, all kinds of sleeplessnesses happen because of these things, okay? Let's go down. And verse 13. And the Lord said unto the woman, what is this that you've done? The woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. All of them pointing fingers. And you know they say, when you point one finger, guess what you're doing? You are pointing three to yourself. You point a finger this way, look at my hand. You point a finger this way, look at it. You point one finger, it's her that did it. What you do, you're pointing three fingers back to yourself, and one you're pointing to the devil. Same thing that was going on here. They asked Adam, and Adam said, it was him that did it. He said, it's the serpent that did it. So you see, you're pointing somebody else. You got three coming to you, and then you have one saying, the devil made me do it. All of that in pointing fingers. Now, why three? Because it was a choice you made. You could have decided not to do it. So even if somebody, let me say, was one that instigated you, the greatest responsibility, that's why it's three fingers, lies with you. The greatest responsibility to make right choices lies with you. Okay, but let's go down a little bit. Let's go down some more. We're going on a rabbit trail here. And the Lord said unto the serpent, let's leave the serpent alone. Okay, well, let's read it. That is relevant. The Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, you are cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all days of thy life. Now, this is so interesting. This means that the serpent, snakes, used to have feet before. Snakes were not just crawling on the ground, they had feet. And when this happened, the curse that came on the snake, the serpent now went from being upright to being down. Okay, but again, let me say this. I also blame Adam. We saw in Genesis chapter 1, verse 27, 28, the Bible says, God blessed man and God gave man dominion over all the plants, over all the animals, over everything that moves upon the earth. God gave man dominion. God gave man dominion over everything. So Adam had dominion over the serpent. So the moment Eve saw the serpent coming to talk to her, she could have rebuked the serpent. Because they had dominion, they're supposed to subdue every animal. She told the animal, get out of here. Who's that talking through you? She could have done that, but they did not do that. So they were derelict of their duties of taking care of the earth in that sense. But also we see, look at verse 15, very important here. And I'll put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed, and it shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. So God begins to factor in right from the beginning, right at the fall. God begins to factor in the solution, the eternal solution, which was Jesus Christ. God factors in that eternal solution in this scripture, as we see here. He said, the seed of the woman will bruise your head. He will destroy your head. He's going to crush your head. That's how you should read. He will crush your head and that will bruise his heel. There's going to be a little hurt. Christ died on the cross. You know, there was some hurt to that. But ultimately, the devil's authority was crushed on the cross. Okay? The cross, the devil's authority was absolutely destroyed and smashed on the cross. But let's go down to something here. Verse 16. Unto the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow, notice that, and thy conception, in sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband, and he shall rule over thee. More or less, pain. God begins to speak about pain coming in sickness and disease and infirmities. Come produce pain. Every sickness, every disease produces discomfort and produces pain. Okay, let's go down again. Verse 17, and unto Adam he said, because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife, and hast eaten of the tree of which I commanded unto thee, thou cursed the ground for thy sake. In sorrow thou shalt eat of it all days of thy life. Okay, look at verse 19. In the sweat of thy face thou shalt eat bread till thou return unto the ground, for out of it was thou taken, for dust thou art, and unto dust thou shalt return. Now, what are we saying here? We're saying that this is the origin of sickness and disease, the origin of pain, the origin of infirmities, the origin of mental illnesses, the origin of emotional distresses. Everything here, everything we see here shows you the origin of those things. Okay, we're studying about healing here. We're saying healing and health belong to you. Okay, but we're tracking, first of all, the origin. So these things are not the plan of God. We also saw original intent. We saw that God, everything God made was very good. We saw it. God looked back, everything was very good. God set up the Garden of Eden, everything was running great until they ate of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And that's when everything began to go haywire. That was the origin of sickness and disease, okay? The origin of pain, the origin of infirmities, of emotional problems and distresses. All those things are the result of the fall. But in verse 15, God begins to produce, God begins to speak about the cross. Look at verse 15 again as we close up this morning. And I'll put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head. That word actually should be crush thy head. It shall crush thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. A bruise on the heel is a little bruise on the heel. Okay? But it says it will crush the head. Or let me say, in the process of crushing your head, you will bruise his heel. In the process of crushing your head, you will bruise his heel. Christ died on the cross. A bruising. But the cross destroyed the power of the enemy. A crushing. And the Bible says that Jesus took our infirmity and bore our sickness. With his stripes were healed on the cross. Jesus was bruised on the cross. Why he was crushing the enemy's head? Why he was crushing every sickness and disease, every infirmity, every emotional distress? Okay, he was bruised, but the Bible says he crushed the head of the enemy. That means that every believer, everybody in the world actually, has every right right now to return back to original design, to return back to original model. What's the original model? We saw it earlier. We saw God, everything God made was very good. And we know that every good gift, Every perfect gift comes down from the Father of lights. And therefore, Father, we thank you this morning. Lord, we give you praise. Thank you, Father, for showing us that the original plan, the original design, the original intent is that we walk in health, is that everything be very good. And you've given us authority over every animal, over every virus, over every disease, every pathogen, everything that causes problems. You've given us authority. That was the original intent. And Christ, by dying on the cross, restored, or brought us back, just like going to the mechanic, brings back the car to its original intent. God, Christ has brought us back to the place where we can walk in health, but also we have authority over virus, over every disease. And therefore, right now, I command every infirmity, every sickness that seeks to afflict you, I command to leave your body right now. I curse every virus, I curse every bacteria, I curse every fungi that is causing this sickness and disease in your body. I command you to die in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing now in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.